Hi, everyone. I'm glad you're here. Thank you for joining me once again. There was two earthquakes today that USGS is reporting, a magnitude 2.8 and a 1.4. But these earthquakes were actually quite larger. You know, it was almost exactly 1 year today that they were having that earthquake swarm there at Lake Tahoe after a magnitude 3.8 earthquake occurred on April 25th, 2021. Today is April 26, 2022. In those reports that I did a year ago, I talked about the past history of Lake Tahoe. Over here, we got an area, Lake Forest Tuft Ring. That was an area that was created because of a hydrothermal explosion, because of the magma and lava and all the activity that was occurring back then. I also drew out different cinder cones that I could find looking at Google Earth. This is the area up here by Truckee where that 2.8 and 1.4 occurred. And then over here we got Mount Rose. It's an area for skiing where uplift has been going on. And then I talked about Lake Tahoe, how the water is so cold. They got hundreds of bodies down there at the bottom of the lake, still preserved as if they're still just drowned down there yesterday. And that one indication, if the lake was heating up, the bodies would start to decompose, create the gases, and float up to the surface. And then you would get reports of people fighting these bodies with some really strange outfits. You know, they say that history does repeat itself. And I talked about these areas where they had large earthquakes at Lake Tahoe that created tsunamis. Here's an area that had a tsunami that was over 400 feet high. And then down over here, we have an area of another landslide, over almost 4 miles, 3.5 cubic miles of debris fell into the lake, also creating a tsunami. And that tsunami, they feel, may have reached the upper Truckee River Canyon. Yeah, and can you imagine if there was an earthquake today? A large earthquake that created landslides, being in one of the casinos and watching a tsunami coming towards you 400 feet high. Yeah, wow. In the last week by Mount Rose, there's been 3 earthquakes. And they're saying that they're really small, but I think they were larger than what they were. But here by the Truckee Airport, the one earthquake they're saying was a 1.7. But that earthquake was actually a magnitude 2.51. Yeah, they downgraded it. I don't know why they do that. And there's the signature of that earthquake. And then the spectrogram, we'll go back to that right there. So here on the swarm program, you can see it's not a 2.7. It was actually a magnitude 3.12. And we'll go to the signature right there. So on the stream view, this is 2.7. Yeah, it's not. It's a 3.12. And then over here, you can't really see it very well. The signature goes way up here above the 1300 line. Now, this is universal time. And comes all, it's hard to tell, close to the 1500 time. Almost 24 hours earlier, there was this signature here, and similar but not as large as that earthquake that I reported they had in Bosnia. Now, that one in Bosnia lasted over an hour, almost an hour and a half, where this one's probably maybe 30, close to 40 minutes. This is it right there. And I'm wondering if this is not a tremor. Now, the difference between a tremor and an earthquake is a tremor is a slow-moving earthquake that they've been having up there by the state of Washington. They track these tremors. So let's go back over here. And looking at the signature, let's pull this and extract that. It was actually looking like tectonic in nature. Let me pull this up so you can see it. And we'll make this larger. I've talked about the different earthquakes, tectonic or harmonic. See how it's got sharp little points? Tectonic earthquakes is when the plates are moving, the continents are moving. Whereas harmonic or volcanic tremors is when magma is on the move. So here's an image provided by USGS. It shows four different types of earthquakes. The top with the sharp little points is what they call tectonic earthquakes. Earthquakes that got the rounded tops, that is what they call shallow volcanic earthquakes. And then down here they have what's called surface events. Could be rock slides, traffic sometimes. And then this one here is harmonic tremors. Harmonic tremors and volcanic tremors both have rounded tops and is when magma's on the move. But this one looks like tectonic. But it wasn't a sudden jolt of an earthquake. This one lasted for quite a while. So it would be classified as a tremor. At least I hope that's what it was. And nothing man-made because it lasted so darn long. Not as long as the earthquake in Bosnia. But you can see, let me bring it down. 1600 and, probably about 45 minutes. And it continued, let's to 17, maybe 17, let's say 1710. Yeah, there's a small earthquake there, very small. Here's another one I just found that's not being reported at 1140. Yeah, it lasted quite a while. Let's extract that if I can. Yeah, see, sharp tops. Yeah, sharp tops. That one comes in as a magnitude 1.72. Up over here, you can see more quiet tremors or quiet earthquakes. These are tremors. These are not actual popping of the rock. So we'll have to keep an eye on this area, see if we have any more earthquakes. Oop, I went off the line for this 3.1. There we go. And you can see it lasted quite a while and brought up a lot of hot gases. And then let's pull it over. This is that 2 point, but it's been quiet for the last hour probably. Like I said, there's that 3.1 and this is probably that 2.1 and it's been an hour. This is what it's currently showing on the stream view. Yeah, odd that almost exactly a year ago, almost to the day that they were having that swarm after that magnitude 3.8 earthquake that occurred there at the bottom of the lake. These are many of the earthquakes that I marked out that occurred back then. So what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe. And I will talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.